So the goal of what we're going to do is to find out the approximate power and torque of an engine, and we want to be able to create a rough dyno graph.
This is the recording now. We've got a private piece of road here where we can do the acceleration run. So what we're going to do is accelerate from around 1,500 RPM until 6,000 RPM with the camera pointing at the speedometer and the rev counter. And then once we reach 6,000 RPM, I'm going to knock it out of gear and then coast back to the speed that we were doing at 1,500 RPM. And that is going to give us our acceleration times. Okay, so that's the time recorded. Now we're going to put this into a video editing software.
I'm just going to use the timeline here to record how long it took to go through each 5 km/h segment starting at 25 km/h. So I'll just write these numbers down, how long it took to go from 25 to 30, 30 to 35, 35 to 40, etc., etc., all the way up to 95 km, I think it went. And I'll do the same coming back down, and we'll be bolting them into this table that we've created here. So this is the speed, this is the time it took to accelerate, and this is the time to it took to decelerate through each segment. Once we've done that, we can go to the engine horsepower calculator on strikeengine.com and start feeding numbers into it. So it says here about the specs that we need: weight of vehicle, we need to know gear ratios, final drive, tire size, and it gives us a link to this website. So we will find the car that we used. So in this case it was on a Ford Focus Mark 1 1.6. So we need to note down the tire size, which is a 195/60/15, and we also need to note down the gear ratio that we used. So it was a 1.93.1, and the final drive was 4.06 to 1, and we also need to note down the weight of the car. We'll add 150 kilo to this total weight. So we bolt the data in here. So 1356 to 195, profile 16, tire diameter 15, gear ratio used in the run, which was 1.93, final drive is 4.06, and then we will bolt down the times for each segment here. So the first one was 25 to 30 kilometers an hour, and that took 0.9 seconds. So we'll note down these into our table. PS was 28. The Newton meters was 106, and the RPM was 1860. And then we'll just repeat this process for every single segment. So that's all the data in, and we make a chart in Excel. This is what we get. So this is our torque curve here, and this is our power curve here. And what we're looking at is a 2-point moving average, just to smooth it out. And so you can see that the horsepower is around 94, 95 horsepower, and we are looking at a peak torque figure of around 140 Newton meters. And from the factory, we can see that this engine had 100 horsepower and 145 Newton meters. So considering the age of the car, I think this is a pretty good figure. About the graph, and you could get spikes using this method because the gradient of the road is not exactly consistent from the start to the finish. So that is why we're going to do the 2-point moving average, just to smooth things off a little bit. And then it all depends on the how accurate you can judge the acceleration time in the segments. So it's not going to be 100% accurate, but it should give you a ballpark figure of what the engine is making at the flywheel. So that's the video, guys. Hopefully it's helpful. As always, if you've got any comments, or you think this calculator can be improved at all, or you have any observations, you know, feel free to let me know in the comments below. That's it for now. As always, if you like the video, please subscribe. If you're a subscriber already, thank you very much for subscribing. It's appreciated. Look after yourself, and I'll see you again next time.